out of 10 cats does countdown. Sean Locke, John Richardson, Victoria Corin Mitchell, James A. Caster, Natalie Cassidy, Susie Dent, Rachel Riley, and your host, Jimmy Cobb.
Hello and welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show about letters, numbers and conundrums. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's Sean Locke. Sean Locke is a star in that he's full of gas, and if he explodes, he'll destroy everything around him. And joining Sean tonight is Victoria Corin Mitchell. Victoria hosts Only Connect, which has been described as the toughest quiz on TV, presumably by someone who's never had to sit next to Sean Locke on this show. Up against them this evening is John Richardson. John gets anxious about stuff. He's what my old nan would call a worry wart, a fuss pot, a flibbity gibbet, a nut job, a weirdo twat.
Joke's on his nan, though. Dead, right? Dead?
Nan?
Yeah.
Oh, long gone.
Joke's on her.
And John's teammate, James A. Caster. Despite what you might think, James is very popular with the ladies, and those ladies are both his grandmothers.
Dead? Yeah, dead.
John, do you have any habits that annoy your wife?
Well, she told me once she wanted me to lose myself at a festival. And I don't know if she means let rip and have some fun or just go missing. Probably the second one. But I think she wishes I'd let loose a bit more and not be so uptight. But when you're having a conversation with your wife about the things you do that might mean she divorces you one day, it's very difficult to let loose and relax. Especially when you're writing them down.
James, you're up against a very tough competition tonight. Would you describe yourself as...
smart? Yes, I would. Does that answer your question, Jimmy?
Yes, it does. It actually asks it as well.
Very smart, Jimmy. I know all the numbers in a Sudoku. Off by heart. Test me on them.
What are the numbers in a Sudoku?
Pick one at random. 9. 8. Don't help me on any of these. 6.
Oh. What happens when we get to the end?
Well, I ran my mouth off. It's really all that can happen.
You'd
is that
be surprised how tolerant a countdown audience is to just counting.
Well, get ready, cos I think there's at least 50 more. 1. 3.
I think soon you're going to forget which ones you haven't done, and now I'm genuinely gripped.
2, 4, 5. 7.
Victoria, question for you. If you were on death row, what would be your final meal?
Here's my thing with that question. What would you eat on death row? What's your final meal? People ask it. It makes you think about it, because you wouldn't enjoy it, would you? Whatever it was, it would taste of ashes because you're going to be imminently dead. So it's thinking about how much you wouldn't enjoy it that really brings home the awful dread of finite consciousness. Having said all that, probably KFC.
I suppose if you're in death row, food's not really a thing. Not a foodie. You're more killy than foodie.
Sean, you're a very generous man.
Yes.
Do you get involved in helping your local community?
Yes, I do, Jimmy. I've donated quite a lot of money to my local dogfighting arena. Well, I say arena, it's just a container with the lid peeled back. And they offered to name it after me, the Sean Locke dogfighting arena, but I said, no, I don't want to be seen as some kind of local saint. brought a lot of money to the area and dog shit.
Okay. Now, Victoria, have you got a mascot?
I have got a mascot. They told me that I couldn't have my phone on in the studio, and it's tricky because I'm quite addicted to Twitter. So what I quickly did was just printed out the last 10 minutes of Twitter before I came on.
Jesus.
No, just so that I could flick through during the show. Do you know what I mean? Because sometimes when you're away from it, you sort of... You know, you wonder what's going on. So I've just got it here. This is just the last 10 minutes. So I can just to see what's going on. It's not... I like looking at the pictures, you know, like... You know, here's my dog in the snow. Here are my tits. My replies, because the last tweet that I did before I came on, I said, I'm going on Cat Stars Countdown and I'm taking as my mascot a printout of Twitter. So then I can see the replies. This is one of my fans has written, that's not funny, you're not a comedian, I don't know why you even do that props bit at the beginning, I don't laugh. Also, you're a fat cow, Mitchell could have done better. So, you know, that... It gets me in the mood to quiz, so... And I'm just sort of keeping in touch with what's
going
on in the world.
You can flick through those as the evening goes. James, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I have, Jimmy.
What have you got?
When I come on this show, I get very worried that people are going to copy my answers. Because I'm so smart, like we established, they might try and see what I've written. So, I've brought something along that spies use to write in code so no-one can read what I've written. It's my code spy kit. This. And here's how it works, right? This looks like a candle. It's a pen, you idiot! I can write here whatever I like, right? I write whatever I like. I've written your name there.
Right.
Oh, actually, I shouldn't tell you that. It's a secret, because it's a code. What does that say? Probably nothing as far as you're concerned, you moron. Then, look, I've got some paints here, right? And I just get my brush, and then I paint over it. Just like this. This is what all the spies do. Jimmy stinks, that was the secret message. You like that?
I mean, I love it. I think it's...
If I want to write in bold, I bought that. I got this for mistakes. I was like, let's go over them in red and do things that way.
OK. John, have you got a mascot?
There's a lot of holidays in this country, frankly, too many. People waste them with their family, let's be honest. Nobody wants to. Nobody wants an extra day off. You suddenly find you've got one, you're all in the same house. You can't say, do you know what, I've got some shit to catch up on, if you don't mind. So you waste it. Not my new day. I'm launching Admin Day. It's a movable feast. You book it in whenever you want. You tell your family, you tell your friends. Nobody's allowed to contact me on this day. So, Admin Day, or as it's officially known, St. Ryman's Day. St. Ryman is the patron saint of admin. You nominate your Admin Day. And the most exciting part of Admin Day is the month leading up to Admin Day, where you get your admin vent calendar. I think that went fine. Yeah. You pop this on just above your kid's bed.
Are you a little bit out of breath?
I'm all right. I had a hernia anyway. And running up to Admin Day, you open up your little admin vent calendar each day and you pull out a piece of stationery you might need. Your highlighter. Everyone uses a highlighter once, don't they? And then you highlight it across ink, it gets dirty, you put it in the bin. You've got rubbers in there, of course, both kinds. Sometimes the excitement of admin overtakes. Important to be safe. You want some stationery? Might help with the show. You want a pen?
Yeah, man. Oh, no, I don't. Very clever.
Yeah. And we've reached the end of the bit now, and the moment that I have to contemplate putting that thing back down again.
With a hand.
Yeah, thanks.
Sean, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I do, Jimmy. I was lucky enough to be sent recently a copy of a newspaper from the day I was born. 22nd of April, 1963. And here we go. It's the simpler times. And as you can see, some interesting news going on. The ladder crisis had deepened at that point. And as you can see, the national joy as felt tip pens are invented. We're lucky enough, this day is quite an auspicious day, 22nd of April, because it's the day they announced the finalists for the cheekiest chimney sweep competition. So that's another lovely little part of the newspaper. I mean, here, scientists say we're just 10 years away from dry roasted peanuts. PC goes mad. This is about a police constable who went mad. Look at him, you can see he's on the turn there.
Is that, what's the other story at the bottom there?
I think Carol Vorderman joins Countdown, is this. This is a story about the Horsham Warbler. Well, there was a fashion for gentlemen to warble under women's windows.
To warble, sorry?
Yeah, sort of go... Unsolicited warbling. And there's a story about foreign muck. Food survey suggests foreign muck becoming more popular than our traditional boiled stuff. And on the back page, on the sports here, we've got this thing about tennis umpires remain grounded due to deepening ladder crisis. There's one other article I want to find, because it's about... It's the Beatles album, first album, was released that week, and there's a really good piece in here about it. Beatles to release their first album.
Is there a story on the other side of that?
Why don't I get more acting work?
John Knox newspaper from the Daily's first. And over in Dictionary Corner, it's Natalie Cassidy.
Hello.
Thank you very much indeed for being here.
Oh, thank you, Jimmy. It's really nice. It's really nice to be here. Hello.
Are you busy at the moment? Anything coming up?
Yeah, I'm doing up my spare room because my sister Kat has moved out. She's gone to Dubai for like a bit of table dancing for a year. Some people get all the luck. So, yeah.
How's that all going?
Oh, really well, thank you. So I've decided to go floral on the main feature wall, then aubergine on the other three. And then now I know what my scheme is, I could go do Lally and Dunelm. That's the plan.
Sounds great. Anyway, well, it's great to have you back where you belong on EastEnders. You're sort of a regular fixture there now, aren't you?
Yeah, sort of, yeah. It's lovely to be back in the square. I really like it. It's lovely. But, yeah, I just... you get a bit nervous because you never know when someone's going to just, you know, kill you off. Run you over or something.
Yeah. Do you have any sort of backup career plan?
Oh, yeah, I'm a trained electrician.
OK. And with Natalie, of course, it's Susie Dent. Susie recently went on tour. Her show got 5 stars, spread across 5 reviews. Susie, we've got a proper EastEnder on the show tonight. Any favourite Cockney phrases?
People pop up in rhyming slang all the time. So modern rhyming slang kind of riffs on people's names, so Lionel Blair, Flares, and Pete Tong, Wrong. And you, in fact, have a bit of rhyming slang named after you, which is Berkeley Hunt.
And in charge of the numbers is Rachel Riley. Rachel has a degree in maths, physics and quantum mechanics. Using her to do the numbers on Countdown is like using Susie Dent as a glorified spell checker, which, thinking about it, is what we do. Rachel, we've got some pretty smart people on the show tonight. Who do you think is the biggest nerd?
I've been thinking about this, actually. So I checked on the Urban Dictionary definition of nerd, and a nerd is someone whose IQ is bigger than their weight. So obviously it's Countdown's own Mr. John Richardson.
Yeah. That works.
Yeah.
Sounds good. Is that a nice thing?
I think it's a nice thing. I think you're a tiny little fella, but you're very clever. OK, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Beekeeping Kit.
I
Okay, let's count down, everyone, for the first time today. John, James, you get the first pick of the letters.
Would you like to pick, or do you not care?
I'd like at least one consonant in there. That's my only request.
All right.
Go for it.
Let's get that out of the way, and then you can drift off. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Start with D.
The best of all the ones. Vowel, please.
A.
Consonant, please.
T.
And another consonant, please.
R.
Vowel, please.
I.
And another vowel, please.
E.
Yeah, a consonant, please.
C.
And a consonant.
V.
Oh. And a final... Go on.
Vowel.
O.
Oh, no.
OK, and for the first time today, here's the countdown clock. I thought it was a dinosaur, but it's just a dog dressed up.
Is the game fit? No.
Yeah, this is the bit they don't put on telly where we keep going.
Go on. Go on. Hey. Hey. Aww. Fuck off. All right. How many did you get, John?
7.
OK, James?
6.
6.
Yep.
Sean, how many?
6.
Victoria?
I think 8.
Ooh. James, let's hear your 6.
Traced.
Well, I mean, that couldn't be more perfect.
Yes, I was quite happy with that.
Yeah, as well you should be. Your 6, Sean?
Tirade.
John, your 7.
Carotid.
Mm. Oh! Ooh. Yep. As in a sort of carotid artery sort of thing. Yeah.
Yeah, excellent.
Thank you.
Oh, good countdown word, that one.
Victoria, Cara Mitchell.
Cavorted.
Brilliant.
Oh, lovely.
Cavorted. Cavorted. So, hey, that's pretty impressive. I mean, for Cats Countdown, that's a remarkable thing.
Yeah.
That never happens. Could they have done any better?
Susie's written down deviator. 8. So that's as good as 8. So it's equal.
So at the end of that, Sean and Victoria are in the lead with 8. Impressive. OK, on to our first numbers round. Sean, Victoria, you get the pick of the numbers.
OK, I'll have the usual, please.
The usual Shawnee special. 2 from the top, 4 little. And they are 2, 7, 3, 10, 125. And the target... 5-6-1.
Okay, so your target is 5-6-1. Your time starts now. Candles down. OK, so, Victoria, did you get it?
I'm nowhere. I can make 7.
OK, Sean, did you get it?
No, well... yeah, I reckon I did get near it.
OK, John, did you get it?
Got 560.
Oh!
James, did you get it?
500 I got.
OK, so, Sean, did you get it?
Yeah.
How did you get it?
Well, let's have a think about this.
Just explain your method.
I reckon the 25.
Would the 25. Yeah.
Times something like 3. 3 times 70. No. I reckon it's
the 100.
By 100.
Why am I helping this bullshit?
It's 4.
100 times 25.
100 times 25 is 2,500.
Oh, 100 minus 25.
Yeah, and then you times that by 7.
Yep.
And that gets you to 525. Then you add your 3 with your 10. That's times 3 times 10. With 2.
Well done, Sean.
Yeah.
Amazing.
I got it right.
Yeah, 561. Well done, Sean.
Fair enough.
Good.
Yes. That's how you... That's one way of doing it.
John, how did you get 560 for the points?
Really? You could see the cracks in that, could you?
John?
25 plus 3.
25 plus 3, 28.
Times 2.
Times 2, 56.
Times 10.
Oh, that'll do.
Really
one away.
Clever.
Yeah. So at the end of that, I can tell you that Victoria and Sean have 8, John and James have 7. Well, time now to go across to Dictionary Corner. Natalie, what have you got for us?
Well, basically, it's a bit unprofessional, but I've got a voiceover tomorrow and I need to practice with somebody and it's for a radio thing. Will you do it with me?
Yeah, sure.
Is that OK? It's a bloke's part, that's you. And we'll just play it natural, yeah? Is that all right?
Yeah, sure. Go ahead.
Hello, I'm Natalie Cassidy, and let me tell you, like a lot of busy British mums, stress don't half go to my bum. I mean, here I am, getting ready for a celebrity party and trying to get the kids to bed, like I feel it flaring up already.
Maybe I can be of assistance.
Who are you, then?
I'm the bum fairy.
There's no such thing.
Yes, there is. And whatever's wrong with your bum, Bum Fairy all-purpose bum cream for busy mums does the trick. So, how can I help?
Well, you could start by helping to calm down the heat rash that came on this afternoon when I went to Laser Quest in a pair of thick tights.
That sounds like... That sounds like a bummer.
You're telling me... You're telling me, mate. And it hasn't made it easier that I've been eating nothing but strong cheddar all week.
Oh, it sounds like you need my soothing action.
I wouldn't say no, mate. Especially with these bloody piles playing up.
Let me take care of that.
Cheers, mate. What did you say your name was again?
I'm the bum fairy. I'm starting to think, is this whole bit just designed so I say, I'm the bum fairy?
Susie baby to it.
Natalie Cassidy, everyone. And here is your teaser. The words are less but and the clue is be discreet. That's less but, be discreet. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were less, but the clue was be discreet. It was, of course, subtlest. OK, so Sean and Victoria are in the lead.
Yes.
On with the game. Time for another letters round. Sean and Victoria, your turn to choose.
Could I have a consonant, please?
R.
And another consonant?
S.
And another consonant?
N.
Vowel, please.
I.
Vowel.
U.
Another vowel, please.
E.
Consonant.
T. Ooh.
Consonant.
B.
Do you want a vowel or a consonant?
Oh, I like a... Oh, I'd like a consonant, please.
Another consonant.
And why?
Oh, I wish I hadn't had a consonant. I feel a bit sick.
OK, your time starts now.
Okay.
John, how many?
Seven.
James, how many?
Gonna put the candle down. I got seven.
Seven? Sean, how many?
Six.
Can't take your eyes off it, can you, Sean?
Wish I had one like that. Instead of this monster.
Victoria, how many?
I mean, I'm incredibly distracted.
Yeah.
Why?
It's just a lovely shower cap, isn't it?
I mean,
Victoria, how many?
I'll say seven. I don't know if it's a word. I don't know if I'm saying words now.
It's a funny place to have a piercing.
I'm gonna get my dressing gown. Hang on.
I've done this show three times. That's happened twice.
Big hand there for Jimmy's tiny knob.
Sean, what was your sex?
Berries.
Berries? Ah, probably inspired by my testicles.
There's another word on there, inspired by your dick.
Victoria, you're seven.
Bunters? Is that a word?
Susie Dent, is it a word?
No, I'm afraid not. It's his proper noun, Billy Bunter. Sorry.
James, you're seven?
Bruisey.
Bruisey.
With an E.
With an E.
No.
No.
Not there, I'm afraid.
John, you're seven?
I think I was influenced by you as well, Jimmy. Bustier.
Good.
You got a cracking set.
7 points to John. Natalie Cassidy off of EastEnders, could they have done any better?
Yes, there's an eight. What Susie's written down is turbines.
OK, so at the end of that, Sean and Victoria have eight, John and James have 14. OK, they've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for John and Victoria. Oh. John, your turn to pick the numbers.
I would like six small ones, please.
No big ones. Coming up. One. Three. Eight. Five. Four. And seven.
Oh, my God.
And the target, 299.
Oh. OK, and your time starts now.
Come on, John.
Yeah, go on, John.
Go on, John.
This really helps me when you both shout at me.
Come on.
Go on,
I reckon you've got the best chance at.
Thank you.
Come on, John, you prick.
You're so good at numbers as well. There's no way anyone could ever beat you.
Oh, you are an arsehole. You are an arsehole.
Ask John first.
I reckon John's only gone and bloody done it, hasn't he?
No, he might have if people weren't shouting at him the whole time.
Victoria, did you get it?
No, I didn't get it.
Oh, I've got it, I've got it, I've got it.
No, he hasn't got it.
And not for telly, but for just for my life.
How did you get it?
Five fours are 20.
Yep.
Eight plus seven is 15.
Yep.
Multiply them together.
300.
And take off the one.
Lovely. 299.
OK, well, no points to anyone on that round.
Yay!
OK, so Sean and Victoria have eight, John and James have 14. OK, time now to go over to Dictionary Corner. Natalie, are you sticking around for a drink after the show?
I'd love to, but I've got to go to charity shop.
Are you donating?
Yes, it makes me feel good, giving stuff to charity.
It's very conscientious of you. What are you dropping off?
Well, what have I got here? Oh, my little Jane McDonald CD. In very good condition, even though I played it within an inch of its life. But, Jane, if you're watching, I am still your biggest fan. I've just got you on Spotify now, babe. Oh, this isn't going to be a hard goodbye. My little wooden owl. I used to do me lesbian Sonia lines to him. Cool, dear, if owls could talk, eh?
It seems a shame to get rid of that.
Yeah, but I don't know, he just looks a bit... He's looking at me funny, do you know what I mean? He's a bit noncey.
Yeah, owls can be like that.
Oh, here we go. This is my 2001 British Soap Award winner's basket, hamper basket.
Are you sure you're ready to let go of the box? It sounds pretty precious.
Well, the thing is, Jimmy... past is another country, ain't it? I mean, 1 minute, you're just a little girl flying across the gymnastics floor like paper in the wind. Next minute, you're acting on a TV set with Michael Greco. And suddenly, it's the Soap Awards 2001, and you wake up pinching yourself, and there's a hamper on the doorstep full of cheese and pickles and breadsticks and things you'd never dreamt of. And you're too young to drink the wine, so your dad tucks in. And he's half cut, and he tells you that you're something proud. And it's enough, you know. Say that, I'll keep the dog toys in it.
Natalie Cassidy, everyone. And here is your teaser. The words are fireplop. The clue is not as hard as you thought. That's fireplop, not as hard as you thought. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the cheese of the words were fireplop. The clue was not as hard as you thought. It was, of course, floppier. OK, time now for a quick bonus round. Victoria hosts Only Connect, which is the smartest quiz on TV. But this is Cat's Countdown. So, once again, we're going to test our teams with the stupidest quiz on television. OK, picture round first. Take a look at this. Can you tell me, is that a picture of James Acaster's hair or a Highland cow?
That's James's hair.
No.
I think that's a Highland cow, personally. And if it's me, it's going to be the worst day of my life.
So, James and John are saying Highland cow. Sean and Victoria are saying James Acaster.
Oh, that... so help me God, that better be a Highland cow.
OK. Well, I can tell you, it is a Highland cow.
Yeah! Thank God.
A little bit of fun for you. That that picture was taken in 2016, so that cow is now dead.
What happened to it? Did it walk into a road and couldn't see what was coming?
Classic fringe accident. I think you'll be all right on that front. Time to test your celebrity knowledge
now. That was tense. Sean looked like he was going to spark you out.
Time to test your celebrity knowledge now. We've got pictures of some celebrity waxworks from Louis Tussauds in Niagara Falls. All you have to do is identify them. So, who is this? It's a feverish and frankly ill-looking gentleman. Who do you think that might be?
What is that? Is that a waxwork or a person?
That is a waxwork of a person. OK, so, what have you gone for? James?
John Travolta.
John Travolta? It's a pretty good guess. That collar doing a lot of the work there. Sean, who do you think?
Steven Seagal.
Let's have a look. It is, in fact, Tom Cruise. OK, next waxwork. This should be easier.
I don't know.
Could you just zoom in on the name badge?
It's quite fitting, answering these questions with a candle, isn't it? That's enough to make a whole John Richardson, that is.
OK, so who do you think?
Princess Anne.
See, we're seeing it at different angles. I thought it was Art Garfunkel.
You know a waxwork is not brilliant when you can't tell whether it's Art Garfunkel or Princess Anne. Who do you think it might be, John?
Helen Daniels.
So Neighbours. It's a waxwork museum in Niagara Falls.
Yeah.
And but, you think it might be Helen Daniels off of Neighbours?
As she looks now.
It is, in fact, our Queen. That is a waxwork of the Queen. I mean, we tried to help them along with the crazy hair they've decided our Queen definitely has.
Oh, Princess Anne was close. I should get points for Princess Anne. It's when the Queen was going through her Princess Anne phase.
OK, last question. Which one of these is not a real person? Weather presenter, Sarah Blizzard. Spider expert, Anne Webb. Policeman, Nick Lance. Dentist, Bath Toothman. Footballer, Mark DeMann. and vasectomy specialist, Dr. Dick Chop.
I mean, Bath Toothman, I don't think I understand what the joke is.
It's just he's got a dentist, he's called Toothman.
Right, I see. Well, that must be real, cos it's not funny. Like my latest DVD. We think it's Policeman Nick Ladds.
I think it's your least funny so far.
Do you? I'll take the insult. It's what we do. But the round of applause can fuck right off. There's a camera on the audience. I'll be watching this footage back. You've all had to apply. You've all had your bag searched. There's an address for every one of you on that list. And you can expect some warbling under your windows.
OK, so you're saying the fake one is Nick Ladds. What do you think, Victoria?
Well, I thought C as well, so if not, then B.
Really?
The spider expert, yeah.
Really?
You say, go on, we'll say F then. F.
No, you choose.
No, you know.
Because I've been wrong every time.
You're wrong about my fucking DVD.
You're going F? Vasectomy specialist Dick Chop. Well, I can tell you the answer is C. Policeman Nick Ladds is not real. OK, so, John and James, you are the winners of the Stupid Quiz on TV. 5 bonus points to you.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
OK, on with the game. John and James, your turn to choose the letters.
Didn't enjoy that at all.
We didn't do well.
I'm like a racehorse, Jimmy. I'm a pedigree. Countdown quiz man. I'm not just some donkey you drag in to spot waxworks and stupid bits of fucking hair. I'm an artist.
OK, on with the game. OK, John, James, choose your letters.
Can I have 5 vowels and 4 consonants, please?
Sure. Going long on the vowels. A, O, E, I, O. We've got M, S, T, and H.
OK, and your time starts now. James Acaster, how many did you get?
5.
5?
Yeah.
No, that's OK. John, how many?
6.
Sean?
Yeah, well, that's a top countdown player.
A specialist, I believe you said.
Yes.
A racehorse.
The ground was not quite right for me today. I felt that it was 5.
You got 5, did you?
5, yes.
Victoria, how many did you get?
Well, 6. Again, it might not be in the dictionary, but I've got 6.
OK. You're 5, James?
Apologies to people who don't like this word. Moist.
Fuck away, sir.
Sean, you're 5?
They say there's no S in team, don't they? But there is in steam.
He's back to his best.
Oh, that is a... You know what? That right there, that's a racehorse. That's a professional countdown player. OK, John, you're 6?
Smooth.
Smooth?
They say there's no S in mooth.
Oh. That's annoying, isn't it?
Victoria, what happened?
No, I've just noticed there's an 8, but I didn't say 8, so let's stick with 6.
What was the 8 that you didn't say?
Smoothie.
Yeah,
you missed by a bee's dick.
That's not what I got, though.
You should have got that, John.
Homies.
Yes, and you can put a T on there for homiest.
I wondered about homiest.
It's kind of American for homely.
Natalie, did you get any?
Yeah. Moths.
I like the way you said it. I think that might be a 9-letter word, the way you pronounce it.
If you take your time saying it, it sounds like there's more letters in there. Moths. Your tongue's too big for me mouth. What's the problem?
It's quite a Jamie Oliver tongue, isn't it?
At least I've got eyes that I can actually see through.
Well, now, I've got
people
eyes...
People who throw stones. People who live in glass houses. Shouldn't be, you know, have little piss holes in the stove.
OK, so at the end of that, Sean and Victoria have 14, John and James have 25. And here is your final teaser. The words are ripe nads. The clue is see your doctor. That's ripe nads. See your doctor. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the tease, the words were ripe nads and the clue was see your doctor. It was, of course, sprained. OK, time for our final letters game. Sean, Victoria, your turn to choose. And you can still win this.
I'll have a consonant, please.
S.
And a vowel.
A.
Consonant.
T.
Vowel.
E.
Consonant.
L.
Vowel, please.
U.
Consonant.
F.
A vowel, please.
A.
And a consonant.
And L.
OK, and your time starts now. Sean's real age, 67. Susie on the wine, 69. John's a bore, 44.
Bingo! Bingo!
Bingo!
No! I said it first. I said it first. It's mine. It's mine. No, it's mine.
Oh, whoa. You can both have a toaster. Sean, how many?
No, ask John.
Sorry, Sean, my apologies. John, how many?
Seven.
Seven? OK. How do you feel about that, Sean? James, how many?
Definitely got six.
And is there a riskier one?
There's a seven that I'd never heard said as a word before that I kind of...
But you're a maverick. You don't play by everyone else's rules. I'd say go for it.
And sometimes I need to be reminded of that.
OK, so seven from John, seven from James. Victoria, how many?
Well, there's a definite seven.
Seven. OK, what about you, Sean? How many?
Six, Jimmy. But he's only one less than seven.
Yeah. What's your six?
Flutes.
Sorry, how's that pronounced?
Excuse me. Flutes.
James, you're risky seven.
This is not a word. I'll put sateful.
Sateful?
You know, sated, like if you feel sated.
Yeah.
And some words end with full.
Sateful. Sateful, is it a word, Susie? Don't be a dick about this.
No.
Come on, Susie, check proper. It's under S.
John, you're seven.
Fullest.
Fullest.
Mmm.
Oh, a begrudging round of applause. Mm. Victoria, your definite seven, that's definitely a word?
I had fullest as well, although, for the sake of variety, maybe fatal you can have in the plural.
Only with fam.
OK, well, in that case, fullest.
7 points to both teams. OK. Natalie Cassidy, could they have done any better?
No.
OK, so Sean and Victoria have 21, John and James have 32. OK, fingers on buzzers, time for today's countdown conundrum.
I'm not going to bother, cos you can't win, so... I might as well just go back to the paddock, cool down, chow down on some oats and prepare for the next race. No, I'm not even going to look. No, cos I'm so trained, once I look at it, I'll have to try and get it. You know?
Oh, it's a shame we haven't got Sean's blinkers.
There you go, yeah.
Be careful with him when you're buzzing as well, because he's easily startled. Your time starts now.
Ducklings.
John. Ducklings. Let's have a look. Oh. 3 seconds. 3 seconds. So the final scores are Sean and Victoria have 41. John and James are the winners with 42. So congratulations to John and James. You're now the proud owner of this, the Countdown Beekeeping Kit. Thanks to all our panellists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Derry Girls, all seasons completely free. Stream the box set right now on All 4. Aisling B, she's got a new comedy on Channel 4, This Way Up. And tonight, she's Mo Gilligan's Bezzy. Plus David Schwimmer, The Latish Show. Up next.